Graduates, what can we say except congratulations and thank you? Congratulations for your well-earned degree and for all that your degree says about your potential to do great things in this world. I say thank you because we very obviously are appreciative of your patience and commitment to our university as we've joined universities all around the world in adapting during some very strange times. Things got weird, and then they only got weirder. Our faculty began a process in mid-February to be ready to transition to an online environment later in the spring. With the move to online, faculty began becoming more patient with students, and students more patient with faculty. We had to cancel all sort of year-end celebrations where we lift up our student body for its excellence, and sadly, had to cancel our traditional commencement ceremonies for you, our spring graduates. Most importantly, we've all juggled our personal lives in which loved ones and neighbors have struggled with COVID-19. We've accepted the upset to our normal lives and routines, and we've faced economic conditions that are threatening any assumptions about the immediate future. Whatever normal is anyone's guess. And on top of that, we've all endured the phenomenon that is Tiger King, and have come to near universal agreement that Carol killed her husband and fed him to the tigers. 2020 has indeed brought challenges and setbacks, ones that were perhaps unimaginable as we turn the page on 2019, but challenges that we are all working together to meet. I'm not going to lie to you, it will not be the last challenge that you face in your life, but I'm also confident that you were well positioned to thrive in unsettling times. I know the character of our graduates is to face challenges, to lean into hard work, and to make positive differences in the world. A big part of making a positive contribution to your world is cultivating relationships with your fellow man. I recently saw a bit on CBS Sunday Morning where the contributor was reflecting upon the valiant healthcare workers and how we've all been called to service in some way with our neighbor. The viewer was reminded that the Hippocratic Oath stresses that there is art to medicine as well as science, and that warmth, sympathy, and understanding may outweigh the surgeon's knife or the chemist's drug. Though we are not all on the front lines of healthcare, we can all be better people and neighbors when we attend to those critical traits of warmth, sympathy, and understanding. We're proud of you as you exit this great university and go into the world as ambassadors for the values that we all hold dear. I wish you all great success and dearly hope that you will all strive to make that positive impact on your world. I thank you for allowing me a few moments. Congrats again. Best of luck as you begin the next chapters of your incredible journeys. Go Bears!
Hi, my name is Patty Poulter and I'm the provost here at the University of Central Arkansas. We want to take this time to say congratulations. We are so proud of your accomplishments. Even though we can't physically be together to celebrate, please know that you are in our hearts and in our thoughts. No matter what you do next, whether you have a role on a world stage or a quiet life in your community, there's something that no one can take away from you, and that is the degree that you have earned from the University of Central Arkansas. And that degree represents so much. It represents that you have triumphed over challenges, that you have made incredible relationships and friendships, that you have learned to lead, to think deeply about complex problems, and that you will be a change maker in the world. Once again, we congratulate you. We miss you. Keep in touch with us, and remember that you will always be part of the legacy that is the University of Central Arkansas.
Congratulations, graduates. I'm Stephen Addison, Dean of the College of Natural Sciences and Mathematics. This is my 36th year at UCA, and it's the first time I won't be part of a face-to-face commencement ceremony. On behalf of our faculty, I want to congratulate you on your achievement. We may not be with you today, but we are celebrating your graduation. You will now be embarking on the next phase of your lives, starting a job or a graduate program or a professional program, or perhaps advancing in your current job. We want to follow you in your careers. I encourage you to keep up with your department, to let us know about your successes and what you do in the future. But this day is about graduation. Congratulations from all of us. We are proud of you. Have a great day and come back and see us when you can.